Hello and welcome to my editing room. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer and I want to show you an image that I created quite a long time back, but this was a really fun image for me because it was really, what's the right word? So fulfilling in person to make. Like, I have the behind the scenes images here of what we used, and I remember just feeling this really great sense of accomplishment for bringing everything together in this space. I don't always do that. I rely on compositing quite a bit, but in this case, I brought everything into the space and I was able to create like that. So here we have a few of the images where we used parts of it. I have my model here, one of my best friends. She's wearing this beautiful outfit, and I've got a little bottle that I put in the sand, a piece of paper that I got so it'd be really long, and even this old pen. And so these are all of the images that I used here. So let's go back to the beginning. This is a pretty short edit, actually, very short. And so what we have is the initial image, really quite satisfying for me. I was able to get close enough to my subject and separate her from the background enough within my camera that the background was really blurry. So she already stood out beautifully in this image. Her hair was moving, the dress was moving, so lovely. So I extended the frame by taking extra pictures up and down, then I added those in, added some new dress on just so there was a little bit more motion. It was a little crooked, so I just fixed that. But this next step is what I really want to focus on today. These clouds. Okay, I love these clouds. I'm kind of obsessed. And I want to show you exactly what's going on here. So I have the clouds. You can see that it has a mask attached to it. So I did cut out around my subject where I didn't want the clouds to be. So that's kind of an annoying part of having to do this is, yeah, the clouds are going to end up on top of your subject. You might want to get them off of there. So I added the clouds in, put a layer mask, erased them off of my subject, and I used blending mode darken for these clouds. So you can see what happens if I use multiply, it's just a little heavier handed. Color burn. I'm just going through a couple of these so that you can see the differences in how they blend. Got lighten, which doesn't do anything. Overlay, too light for me. Soft light, too light. Hard light, too light. Normal. So I'm gonna go back to darken. And within darken, we've got a really good medium here, but do you notice this little area? Let's zoom in. This area is a problem. What happened was it was just too bright for the blending mode, and so it didn't really take to the background of the image. So we need to fix that. So even though the rest of it looks perfect, I just added that little bit in with blending mode normal so that the little tips of the clouds wouldn't be blown out. Such an important skill to really assess the image as a whole. So yes, you know, maybe this layer worked almost perfectly. It blended right in. It looks amazing. But if you overlook something as seemingly simple as the clouds blowing out in a certain area, your image is not going to look professional through and through. People will notice and it's not going to work. So you have to ask every step of the way, how do I fix this little teensy mistake that I've just made? And if you can do that, you'll get to the end of an edit. It just might take a little bit longer. So I added those clouds in, brightened things up, changed color drastically. You can see especially here that I'm adding light onto the subject's face so much. And this is actually one of my favorite poems here. I'll leave the the words to it below. And so we've got light on the face where it wasn't before. Darkening, and this layer is really interesting too. Can you see the difference in her her face and like the detail happening between this and this? I actually softened the image, and so I reduced noise on this particular layer here, and that made a softer image that I really love. So this is one of my favorite pictures from this year that I took it. I just love it. It was at a time when I was really obsessed with poetry. I still love poetry, but I was even more obsessed. And so I made this image as a sort of homage to Gertrude Stein, who wrote the poem in this image. So, go make something this week. In Photoshop, in person, bring everything out to the beach if you can. Do whatever you would desire most, and know that eventually you'll get to the end of it. It can take a while, but you'll get there. Have a wonderful week. Bye.